Imagine creating a critical dataset only to accidentally wipe it out with an unexpected delete operation. How can you recover the deleted data, and moreover, how can you prevent such disastrous mistakes in the future with BigQuery? This video is going to tell you exactly how. The adventure begins with us creating a dataset. For the moment, we'll continue with the default settings. We need some example data to demonstrate the concepts. How will we generate that? By executing a simple SQL query, our secret weapon to fabricate some random data in our table. And guess what? We'll provide the SQL code in this video's description, enabling you to write along with us. With the creation of the table, we have approximately 1,000 records with fake user data. The first sturdy shield we should employ is the art of using snapshots. Snapshots etch a record of your data at a specific moment in time. Even more amazing, BigQuery's time travel feature means this record can be for a previous state of the table, not just the current state. Let's imagine a hypothetical disaster, like an accidental update query that sets all the IDs to zero. Lo and behold, our IDs column data vanishes. But fear not, our earlier snapshot saves the day. We execute a restore operation which resurrects our defeated data table. The table doesn't even have to exist for this restore operation to work. Again, though, we have this marvelous ability to also base snapshots off of the historical state of our data. Even if we didn't have snapshots lying around, we can create them to recover from data issues that are no more than a week old. The snapshot creation can be scheduled as well, and we'll include an example command in this video's description. Another tactic in our BigQuery backup and disaster recovery is using the export feature. In particular, we recommend sending your data to the safe house of Google Cloud Storage. New buckets can be created on the fly here if needed. We have an array of format and compression options for that export. And when we switch to cloud storage, we should see that the backup appears nicely in our bucket. There are numerous methods available to facilitate these table exports. The example we just demonstrated was via the console, but if you want to automate this process, you can consider alternatives such as scheduled queries, the BigQuery command line, API calls, or even SDKs. SDKs are particularly handy if you're using something like Cloud Functions. The final piece of your backup strategy often involves planning for the biggest, worst-case scenarios, such as project deletions or regional failures. When we consider dataset locations, multi-regional data storage already gives us resiliency, thus minimizing the likelihood of data failure. However, we can level up this security by utilizing BigQuery copies to further backup this data. You can find this under the Dataset Copy option for data transfers. For instance, let's use an EU dataset backup. By mirroring to a dataset in a different region or multi-region, we're enabling even more resilience. If we take the advisable step of using a different project for the backups, we additionally gain project-level recovery. We should run these copies on a regular interval. Once the first copy is executed, we'll find that our EU dataset not only contains our table, but also our snapshots. We hope this video has been informative and helpful. We'll keep an eye on the comments section for any questions and want to thank you for watching. Please enjoy responsibly.